balcony was specifically built for Queen Elizabeth's many progresses. Robert Dudley, the Earl of Leicester, created this private block of apartments specifically for Elizabeth and her courtiers. In 1575, she came here for her fourth and final visit, and she stayed here for 19 days, which is the longest that she's ever stayed with any courtier. So Dudley must have been doing something right.
Dudley was known to be Elizabeth's favourite courtier and rumoured to be her lover. So an invitation to spend 19 days at his luxurious castle could have been rather tempting. I'm meeting author and historian Elizabeth Goldring to find out just how far Dudley was willing to go to impress his queen.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hello.
Lovely to meet
so
you.
So lovely to meet you as well.
Well, this is all very fancy, isn't it?
Wonderful, wonderful. Even as a ruin, it inspires awe and wonder, I think.
But what about this? This is all a bit excessive, isn't it? Why did Robert Dudley build this?
The 1575 Kenilworth festivities are traditionally interpreted as a three-week or nearly three-week proposal of marriage to Elizabeth. So it was in many ways a love letter to the Queen, but also designed to show everyone watching that he was grand enough to be a royal consort. And obviously building works such as this were a big part of that.
So all of this must have cost a huge amount of money.
Absolutely. A lot of progress hosts were bankrupted or nearly bankrupted by the expense of putting up the Queen and the court. Dudley, we know, spent an estimated £60,000 in 16th century money on just building works at Kenilworth in advance of the Queen's visit. And that doesn't cover what he would have spent on food and wine and all the other entertainments.
Well, it's one hell of a love letter. I'm itching to see inside.
Okay, let's go.
Well, this is huge.
Isn't it? It's just massive. This basement area, which you see below us, would have been used for storage for all of the Queen's many trunks and changes of clothes and everything she needed for several months' worth of travel around the countryside.
Of which I imagine she didn't travel very light.
You are absolutely right.
Dudley spared no expense. He built several stories of accommodation, including a bedroom and outer chamber, where the Queen could conduct the business of the day. All came complete with spectacular views of surrounding land.
Well, look at this.
Even better views now that we're on the top floor.
The vista. It's like a 360-degree view of perfection of the English countryside.
So we're now on the top floor of Leicester's building in a space that we think was used as a dancing chamber. The Queen loved dancing, Dudley loved dancing, and we know from written accounts of the 1575 festivities that a lot of time was given over to music and dancing.
Dudley certainly cut a dashing figure. Wealthy, powerful, and judging by the dancing chamber, a bit of a mover. But were the rumours of an intimate relationship with Elizabeth really true?
We don't know exactly what happened behind closed doors, but I think there can be no doubt that Dudley was the great love of Elizabeth's life. I think of her many, many suitors, he was the only one she ever seriously considered marrying. I think this was in many ways a great love story.
What an epic party Dudley must have laid on. He may never have actually won Elizabeth's hand, but you can't accuse him of a lack of effort.